If we all hold serve, there's going to be a 9-1 team that stays home. And it's, if we all hold serve, it looks like it's going to be Westminster, if I got my points correct. Yeah. And that just shows you how tough this region is. I can't ever remember a 9-1 team not getting in.
Yeah.
So that, it's brutal.
And your regular season is so tough. It gets you kind of ready for the playoffs.
We've had battle after battle. We've beat some good teams. We've played real well in the fourth quarter. Last week we won on the last play of the game, so we feel like we got some momentum rolling. And next week's another playoff game up at Hereford. So it doesn't get any tougher than Franklin Hereford to end your season. So it's another playoff game next week.
Great. Thanks, Coach.
Appreciate it.
Congratulations, Keith. Real quick, just talk about your offense just coming to life in the fourth quarter in crunch time.
The big guys that we have up front, we got a tough group, and we like to think that when the game's on the line, we can put the ball in Latham's hand, number one. He's going to produce. The kid has just come through time and time again for us, and he's a warrior. And he gets it done. He wants the ball. He made up a running play on his own this week that we put in. He just wants the ball in his hands all the time.
And what year is he?
Junior.
Wow. Junior, yeah. Wow. So the future is he's definitely bright.
He's a leader, absolutely. Yeah.
What's been the biggest improvement in him from last year to this year?
He's had more responsibility as a junior. He played last year as a sophomore. Mm-hmm. And with Clemens having a bad ankle, he hasn't been 100% the last 3 weeks. Eric's gotten the bulk of the carries, and he's just a tough kid. Works hard, great off season. Works hard in the weight room, and he's just a tough kid.
Talk about the play of your defense. I mean, the whole Franklin, it was kind of ironic. I'm sitting there texting people, and it's like the last thing I expected was a 7-7 game of Franklin and Prairie Hall going into the fourth quarter.
Our game plan, we need to take Ian Thomas out of the equation as best we can. Mm-hmm. We know they get him the ball a bunch of different ways. Mm-hmm. So we said let's put somebody right in his face with somebody helping over the top and make them go somewhere else. And, they still cause one to him over the top. Mm-hmm. We know he's a deadly athlete. Our game plan started with stopping him. I think we did a good job.
Other than the kickoff return there, that almost came back and haunt you there.
A kid like that, you're never going to shut him down entirely, but you got to try to limit what he does. The years they've beaten us in the past, it's always on big plays. Mm-hmm. So we tried, hit us with a couple big plays, but we did a good job limiting them, I think.
All right. Well, just talk about getting this win. I know you was talking to Todd earlier. I mean, you're 8-1, looking good, but a 9-1 team's going to get left out, which is kind of tragic. When you
would think sitting at 8-1, you could start looking at playoff plans, mm-hmm. but 8-1's not going to get us in. Mm-hmm. 9-1 is the only thing that's going to get us in. 8-2 is not. So mm-hmm. now we've got to reload and then go up to Hereford, which is never easy. And now we got to beat Hereford to get in. It looks like.
Wow, amazing. 8-2 and be home, that would be,
I've gotten in at 6-4 before. I know in some of the lower classification teams are going to get in at 6-4, 5-5. So we got to be 9-1. And I wouldn't want to play us right now. We're playing pretty good football.
All right, no problem. Thanks, Keith.
All right.
Coach.
Yes, sir.